Right, so here I am for the second episode of my career mode playthrough videos, and I've done a little bit of sort of brainstorming and came up with that the best way would be to build one more rocket to reach the upper atmosphere and then go ahead to build my my airplane. So, because my idea was that with building one more rocket like the previous two launches, we will have one more of this botched together things, but hopefully it would be the last one, because then the airplane would allow us to take a massive leap forward. And in order to do so, we need this radial decouplers. So let's research that node, and whatever that was, and yeah, actually we would have enough science points, I just see, to build our airplane now already, but I think I will just stick with the plan to do this third launch, or now if we can do it now, we will do it now. So let's research aviation, but it takes 90 days to unlock that node. So in the meantime, we can take a look, but I actually never really liked this path testing contracts, unless it is on the launch pad or lander, because it always was very fiddly to me to reach this exact specifications here, this altitude and that speed, and I don't like it. So let's open the Kerbal Construction Time window. Tech. And remove that one. And warp to complete. No, dear. Takes ages. But let's see if we have 5 upgrade points available. So I think we just let's put 3 of them into the research and development, and now we will just keep it that the building of the plane will take a long time, because we can reuse it. So let's just put everything into the R&D. Okay. 16,000 funds. Now we do not have this kind of money now. So let's close it. Tech. But it still takes 89 days, so this brought us absolutely nothing. Let's warp to complete. see if we get some nice contracts. Launch site. There's nothing good in it. So that I previously designed, this one contains the crew cabin and some other stuff that we are not able to use. So let's build a new one. Let's take the Mark I cockpit. It's not going to be a good one, I can tell. So we do get swept wings, but what we do not get is some elevons that are designed to put on a swept wing. Flaps. This one will be the aileron, the rudder, and the elevator. So we did that one. It's nose heavy. We will have to move the wings back. Forward, what am I saying? So and luckily what I did is move this retractable landing gear into the aviation tech tree node, because otherwise we would have to make do with this stupid fixed landing gear, which is just actually this plane is already, it's ugly enough, so it won't have made too much of a difference. So let's put them around here. Okay. Rotate them to the side. Change this to an a tailwheel arrangement. So like this, and then this tailwheel. Well, but this is nose heavy. Nose heavy like you wouldn't believe it. Disable steering. And it's the ugliest plane imaginable. So let's go to the science experiments. As far to the tail as possible. Not good. So let's select Jebediah, is good. And yeah. Let's head out to the runway, or actually we will have to build it at first. So let's see, it will take 51 days to build. This one. And ah yeah, I exceeded the part count limit by one part. So let's remove the cardboard box because it gives almost no science points. And now we can build it. Show height build list, SPH. Let's grab both of them because I don't know which one is the good one. Hide the build list and build it. Don't save because I want to forget it as quickly as possible. So KCT and warp to complete. So, let's launch it. Everything ready? So, but before we are going to crash it, we will do it. A little bit of rolling on the ground. No, wait, there was supposed to be... There was supposed to be the false science not enabled. Not good. Okay, so let's just extend our lab and have a look at what it looks like. I just realized that maybe I do not even know if I have researched the survivability mod and looking good. I think the best way, or the best thing to do now is quit and have a quick look if I actually have installed for science correctly, because yeah, I will tell when I have checked what I am going to do and what is my plan. Right, so here we are back, and what I have done in the meantime is I have installed the for science mod, because unsurprisingly, this plane does not fly. I kind of expected that when building it in the SPH, because it is way too the nose heavy. And yeah, but what we still can do is just roll it around in the Kerbal Space Center, which I'm now starting to do, because it still has this number of experiments at the tail, and the for science mod now will automatically perform this experiment and then store it inside the cockpit. So because every building here proper in the KSC counts as its own biome, so we can do the experiment in each one of them and then collect some science to hopefully advance a little bit more in the country. That's not what I was looking for, but it's that. And
basically this, there you can see it automatically connected all the experiments. And this is the reason why, if I have the For Science mod installed, which I did not in the first episode, I deactivate it on launch, because otherwise it would collect science of the atmosphere and everything, which I do not want. And usually if I do some like real space missions, I deactivate it too, because it kinda takes away a little bit of the sense of exploration by just doing everything automatically. You do not see anything, but to just collect some science, because you need science. It is great, you build an airplane or something with a lot of experiments placed on the side, and just roll it around and fly it around over a turbine, and it will just automatically collect you a lot of science. Or of course build preferably a rover instead of an airplane, and drive around on the KSC. Oh, I broke. And this is the first crash. But no collision ribbon, or no collision ribbon for Jebediah Kerman here. Yeah, anyway, I think we have collected some science and we can head back into, or we can recover the vessel. Do the normal recovery, because obviously it's not of much use anymore.
I am back.
And yeah, 161 science points. I think this is by far the most successful mission that we had so far, even though the airplane itself was not very successful. It did not fly and it did crash. But yeah, a lot of science points is something nice. And he already got the research 4 ribbon, because in my opinion the amount of science points that a Kerbal needs to get to collect to get this science ribbons from the Final Frontier mod is way too low. I think the highest amount is, or the highest ribbon would be after 2000 science points. And that is something that I can easily get to in one of my more advanced moon missions. You can take a look at the Saturn V video, which actually is, I believe, the first Kerbal Space Program video that I ever uploaded. And in this Duna mission, which I also took a video from, I think it came out with way over 20,000 science points. So all Kerbals very quickly will get this Research 10 ribbon very, very quickly. So anyway, all the scrap has been collected already too, so we can head into the research and development department and take a look on what we can do with all this science that we have collected. And yeah, we won't need that for now, but we will need this one. And the launch escape system still is not in here, but so we won't have too much too much use of this one. But what we can do is research this one to get a lot of science, or a lot of science parts, which I can already tell will be important in the next episode. So we can research that one, and still have 93 science points left. And with 93 science points, the best thing to do
I'd be one. We won't need that one. So let's just keep the 90 science points. You think it is the best that we can do, or yeah, we will keep them. So anyway, I think this concludes the episode of the airplane that does not fly. But I already have my plans for the next airplanes, which will come in some future episode, and for the next episode, which will be some high altitude and suborbital unmanned research rockets. So again, if you liked it, you can feel free to leave a like and subscribe to this channel, and you can also check out my main channel. And I hope to see you again in the next episode with this high altitude rocketry.